Welcome to the SEO.co Search Engine Optimization Podcast. Digital marketing essentials and next level tactics. From offsite and onsite optimization to persuasive selling and everything in between. You'll learn actionable tips on what it takes to outright and outrank your competition.
Welcome back to another episode of the SEO.co podcast. We're continuing the series How to Start an SEO Company. In this episode, we're going to move into choosing your services as an SEO agency. You'll need to think about what kinds of services you're going to offer. Yes, obviously SEO services, but as you know, SEO has many constituent parts, and you may offer some or all of them. You may also offer peripheral services tangentially related to SEO or otherwise enhancing your client's SEO performance. There's an important tie-in to choosing a niche here. If you select one SEO service as a field of specialty, that can come to define you as an agency. For example, you could specialize in writing on-site content, foregoing other services at least temporarily to minimize competition and develop a strong reputation. However, most SEO agencies benefit from offering multiple different services, especially together as a package. These are some of the most commonly considered. First, SEO audits and analyses. The first step in most SEO campaigns is conducting an audit and/or analysis. Depending on your clientele, that will likely mean looking at the technical structure of the site and recommending improvements, analyzing their backlink profile, and looking at the performance of their historical content. Occasionally, clients will pay for this service, then try to execute your recommendations on their own. More often, the quality of your analysis will convince them that they need your help in other areas. Because of this, some SEO agencies offer an initial audit for free. Next, keyword and competitive research. Keyword selection is one of the most important elements of any SEO strategy. If you choose high-volume, low-competition words relevant to your client's industries, then you'll have a much higher chance of success. That said, keyword research takes a lot of time and effort, especially if you're working exhaustively and from scratch. You may consider offering it as a separate line item. Next, technical on-site SEO. Technical SEO is all about making on-site changes to ensure a website is crawled and indexed properly, and making sure it follows Google's best practices for site structure. It's generally a one-time collection of fixes, like optimizing for mobile devices, cleaning up sloppy code, and improving the navigation. Consider treating it as a prerequisite for an ongoing campaign, or offering it as an optional additional service. Next, ongoing on-site content. High-quality on-site content provides you with opportunities to optimize a site for specific keywords, boost the authority of a site, and establish assets you can link to later. Every site needs strong on-site content regularly for SEO. The question is, do you want to be the one to provide it, and do you want to charge for it per item or as part of a weekly or monthly fee? Next, off-site content and link building. You should also think about link building. Links are the only reliable way to increase your domain authority and page authority, which will support your rankings in search engines. The best way to build links is with off-site content on high-authority external sources. This is an issue for many SEO agencies, since a successful link-building campaign relies on good relationships with external publishers, and that takes time to establish. Fortunately, there are alternative options here, like outsourcing to a link-building agency. Next, ongoing analysis and support. Most SEO agencies provide ongoing analyses and support to all their clients, no matter what. However, you may offer different tiers of support. For example, will you produce comprehensive reports on a weekly basis or a monthly basis? How often will you hold client meetings? What steps will you take if the client isn't seeing the results they want? Lastly, social media marketing and other services. If you want to be a comprehensive marketing agency, you might offer other services like social media marketing, PPC advertising, and even website design. However, you should be confident in your ability to offer these services competently. Don't just throw them in because you can. You also shouldn't stretch yourself too thin when you're just starting out, so consider starting with a specialty and expanding from there. You'll also need to figure out a way to assemble these into comprehensible packages and set reasonable SEO pricing, keeping in mind that making your SEO services cheap is ill-advised. Most SEO agencies attempt to get clients on a retainer, so SEO is a long-term strategy. So it's much easier to prove your worth and get results over a period of many months. Plus, the consistent revenue makes it easier to manage your business. Consider offering a bronze, silver, and gold package, or a similar assortment of increasingly effective and expensive packages. For example, your bronze package might include one new on-site post per week, one new high-quality link per week, and a handful of other supportive services, while your gold package includes three new on-site posts per week, three new links per week, and even more peripheral services. Alternatively, you could offer your SEO products and services in an a la carte format. You could charge a fixed rate per link, per post, or per hour of work. Just make sure your clients understand the importance of consistency and long-term effort for SEO. And that's all we have for this episode. In our next episode in this series, we're going to dive right into developing an online presence for your SEO company. Thanks again for listening to the SEO.co podcast, and we'll see you in the next one.
Thank you for joining us on the SEO.co podcast. We appreciate your time. Be sure to rate, review, and subscribe to the show and visit SEO.co for more resources based on today's topic, as well as access to more podcast episodes to help you improve your site's long-term SEO success.